Ready when you are.
Do you need your outline? You can't freeze the screen and go somewhere else on your computer. It just has to stay plugged in.
There's a freeze button. Oh,
okay.
Oh, seriously. So it's not the computer doing it, it's the projector doing it.
Yeah.
I've never seen that before.
So this is a flashback of my childhood. This is me when I was, so this is me the night after I was locked down in a chair in a meth lab. It was blown up and I had to go through a withdrawal program at the hospital and I had to stay there for 2 weeks. And then this is the bump on my forehead that saved my life from that, because the meth lab was blown up, all like the fumes and stuff were going into me, and I was such a small child that if I didn't get hit in the head with a piece of metal, I wouldn't be here right now. So that's that. So after that, I had to go to court with my real dad and my mom, and the judge told my dad that if he paid 8 consecutive months of child support, which is $100 a month, that he could have custody back of me, even after all the things that he did to me, and even after this incident, because Michigan is a father's state. So I believe that mother and father states should not define the court system, because a normal person would see that, oh, like her father does these things to her, like she needs to live with her mother. But because Michigan was a father's state, that they didn't see it like that. They saw, oh, the father should always win. The father should always get custody. Father and mother states result in the wrong conclusion almost 90% of the time because nobody sees the real story. They see father and mother states, like, again. Father and mother states also cause a lot of damage to kids. When I was little, I wanted to live with my mother, but because there's an age where you can't say, like you have to be 14 in order to say who you want to live with, so I was always sent to my father's house, and that always led me to be a naughty kid and to lash out. I believe that we should remove father and mother states in whole, and that you should just focus on the story and not think about, like, oh, it's a father's state, so even though this guy molests his child, he's still gonna get custody of her. I think that that's so wrong, and it just makes every single judge who believes in that look horrible. Father and mother states result in the wrong conclusion. So, like, if you are in a mother state and your mother is abusive, your mother will still get custody of you. If you're in, like, a father state, like, it's all the same thing. And 99% of father states and mother states, like, if you're a father and a mother state, 99% of the time, whatever state you are, that person is going to get custody of the child, no matter what. The Attorney General states that 80% of judges use father and mother states. So, no matter what judge you get, they probably use father and mother state. After you're in court 4 times, you're ordered to go to mandatory court therapy. So, if you go to court 4 times, you have to go to court therapy, which is also really bad on children, and that is most likely because of father and mother.
When you say you, are you talking to the kids or the parents?
Kids.
Okay.
After you've been in court 4 times, you're required to go to 3 weeks of court therapy as a child. And it's just like one-on-one with a therapist, basically. But it's at the court.
Right.
Because it's the court's therapist.
Gotcha.
So. My solution is, life with my solution would be so much better because anyone in their right mind would see that my mom deserved 100% custody of me and other parents deserve 100% custody of their child. I believe that mother and father states should not define the court system. Yeah, that's basically it.
Okie doke.